Hi student, today I am going to teach electric cells and a battery. So what is electric cell? Electric cell is a device is convert chemical energy into electrical energy. It is made up of two electrodes. One is carbon rod, another one is zinc rod. It contains electrolyte. The two electrodes dipped into the electrolyte. Electrolyte solution acts as a dilute sulfuric acid H2SO4. Here, carbon rod acts as a positive terminal, zinc rod acts as a negative terminal, electrolyte acts as a dilute sulfuric acid. The zinc rod negative terminal react with the dilute sulfuric acid due to oxidation release two electrons. The two electrons reaches the anode, that is carbon rod. So negative electrons are moving from negative zinc rod to positive copper rod inside the circuit. Outside the circuit, it flows from positive terminal to negative terminal. Here, developing potential difference. So electric cell gives potential difference. Next, electric cell symbol. This is the electric cell symbol. It is two terminal. One is positive terminal, second one is negative terminal. It has two types of electric cell. One is primary cell and a secondary cell. Primary cell, it is a rechargeable. Sorry, does not rechargeable. Not rechargeable. It is a irreversible process. Not rechargeable means only one time use. For example, in our house we are using a battery cell, remote cell, then wall clock cell. That's general only one time we can use. Again, we throw it outside. It is irreversible process. Irreversible process means does not come back to original position. Once charge, power lost means lost. Again, we can't able to store again. Then does not produce steady current for long time. For example, Daniel cell and a Leclanche cell. Next, secondary cell. Secondary cell is a rechargeable. Rechargeable means once the battery power lost means we can able to recharge again. For example, in our mobile phone we are using a battery, you know, that is a rechargeable. And rechargeable torch light. Automobiles, we are using a rechargeable battery. That is all secondary cells. It is a reversible process. Then it can supply steady current for long time. It has very low internal resistance. What is the resistance? It opposes the current. The internal resistance, the opposes the current, is very, very low. It can allow the current very high amount. For example, Hedda's recombinator is a secondary cell examples. Next, battery. So what is mean by battery? What difference between cell and a battery? Two or more cells connected in series, that is act as a battery. The series connection, two types of there. One is series connection, second one is parallel connection. So what is mean by series connection? End to end, positive, negative, again positive, negative, again positive, negative connection means series connection. Then parallel connection means all the batteries, that is positive, connected in one terminal. Then negative connected in one terminal. This is called a parallel connection. So two or more cell connected in series or parallel, this is called as a battery. Then, so what is mean by EMF? EMF stands for electromotive force. Electromotive force is not a force. It is used to push the electron from one end to another end. For example, electric circuit, we are connecting battery. So what purpose we are connecting battery? There is no current is flowing. The battery supplies the energy to flow, move electrons from positive terminal to negative terminal. When we are connecting the battery in circuit, electrons are flowing from negative terminal to positive terminal. Work is done. The amount of work done is called as electromotive force. So electromotive force is the source of battery. Thank you, student.